In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up and start using the software you need to get the most from your Bambu Lab 3D printer. This will be a very quick guide to show you everything you need on day one to get printing, rather than a deep dive into all of the software's features that, to be honest, you're probably not going to need for a while. The two main scenarios that you're likely to encounter when needing to use software to 3D print something are, first, finding something you want to print on Bambu Lab's MakerWorld site, and secondly, taking any other kind of 3D model file and printing that. I'll cover both of these scenarios here using as little assumed knowledge or jargon as possible, because I do remember how confusing everything was when you first get started with 3D printing. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. So firstly, why do we even need software? Why can't we just send a 3D model straight to our printer and expect it to print it? Well, very basically speaking, to be able to print something, the 3D printer needs to know where to move the nozzle, the part that the filament is squeezed out of or extruded, at any time. It also needs to know how much filament to extrude at any time. The printer therefore needs to know X, Y, and Z, or Z, coordinates for every movement, and also other information about how much filament to push through. Also, each 3D printer will have slightly different components and dimensions, so we'll need this information compiling slightly differently. Slicer software is the middleman that turns any 3D model into slices or layers and then writes a long list of instructions for your 3D printer to follow to create each layer. There are different options for slicer software, but if you own a Bambu Lab 3D printer, then in my opinion, the best software to use is Bambu Studio. This software is free and contains all of the information needed for every Bambu Lab 3D printer, and after some quick setup, you'll have everything you need to get going. Now, as much as I don't like to, I am going to have to make a couple of assumptions to keep this video as short as possible. I'm going to assume that you have a Windows PC or laptop with Windows 10 or higher, or a Mac with Mac OS 10.15 or above. There is a Linux version of Bambu Studio, but it's not something I've got any experience of, I'm afraid. I'm also going to assume that your 3D printer is set up and ready to print, and ideally you will have printed something from the supplied SD card, as I showed in my A1 and A1 mini setup videos. So, before you can do anything else, you need to download and install Bambu Studio, which you can find from the download link in the description of this video. With the software installed, open it up, and you'll need to select your location and decide whether to participate in Bambu Lab's customer improvement program. Skip or say no if you don't want to. There are no penalties for not sending information to Bambu Lab. At the printer selection screen, select any printers that you have, and then at the filament selection screen, select any filament that you'll likely want to use. It's very easy to add printers or filament later, so it's not too important if you don't get this right. After this, allow the installation of the Bambu Network plugin if you want to take advantage of all of the features I'm going to show, and allow any network permissions if you're comfortable doing so. After successful installation, I'd advise signing in to your Bambu Lab account, or if you don't have one, create one. Again, this is free and it allows you to connect your 3D printer anywhere that you have a network connection and synchronize details between different Bambu Lab apps. I find the most useful benefit is being able to check on the print progress through the phone app if I'm not close to my printer. Now, as good as Bambu Lab 3D printers are, there are some jobs that are just a bit beyond their capabilities. Instead of investing in a new machine for those odd jobs that need more than a home 3D printer can achieve, think about using PCBWay. Have a quick look at the PCBWay website and you'll see that they don't just supply PCBs. PCBWay are fast becoming a one-stop shop for anything 3D printed, CNC machined, laser cut, or even injection molded. Check out their website from the link in the description below for a quick free quote and $5 off your first order. So, once you're signed in to your Bambu Lab account, we're ready to slice our first print. Firstly though, I'm going to briefly introduce you to some of the basic functions that you'll need to get going. Along the top, there are 5 tabs, but we're only going to use the first 3 today. We have Prepare, Preview, and Device. Prepare is where we bring in our 3D model and select the settings we want the software to use when it slices the model ready for our printer. Preview will show us what the software has done after slicing the model to give us a chance to look through the layers to see if we're happy with what it's going to do before wasting any time or filament. And then Device allows us to see the status of our printer before, during, and after a print, and lets us control it and even view the image from the printer's camera live if it has one. If you don't have a connection to your printer, then check that you're signed into your account, that your printer is associated with your account using the QR code on the printer's screen during setup. And then lastly, that your printer is actually switched on and connected to your Wi-Fi. So let's start by finding something on MakerWorld and print it. Click on the home icon at the top left, and then from the menu options on the left, select online models. This will take you to MakerWorld from within Bambu Studio. You can either browse through the models or search for something specific. I quite like printing the Dummy 13 models from Lucky 13 Toys, and they're easy to find with the search function. Click on the file to see if it's something you want to print, and then if you do, click download and open. One thing to bear in mind if you own the A1 Mini is that some larger models won't fit on the printer's smaller bed. To see if the print file is compatible with your printer, have a look at the different print profiles along the top first. This file has an A1 Mini profile, so I can print it easier. The first thing to check after the model has been imported into your prepare page is that you have the correct printer selected at the top. If yours is wrong, like mine is, then select the correct printer from the drop-down list. If you get a warning about settings being changed, select Use Modified Value. With this Dummy 13 model, it's been designed to print in two runs, and Bambu Studio is showing us two plates that we can select between by clicking on them. Before going any further, I'm going to pull through the correct filament that I've loaded on my printer's AMS. You do this by clicking on the icon in the filament heading that says Synchronize Filament List from AMS when you hover over it. Before you do this though, you want to make sure that your printer does in fact know what filament it has loaded, which you can edit at the printer or in the device tab within Bambu Studio. With the filament list updated to match what you actually have loaded, you can now select any part and change the filament the printer will use to print it. You can do this by left clicking to highlight any part and then right clicking and selecting a different filament from the change filament option in the pop-up menu. I'm going to print the skeleton of this model in PETG and the armor in PLA. With any file from MakerWorld that you import, you shouldn't really have to change any of the settings to get it to print, as someone else has done all that for you. If you did want to change anything, then all of the options are under the quality, strength, speed, support, and others tabs on the left. I'm not going to change anything here, and instead I'm just going to select to slice the plate. Depending on the complexity of your model and the processing power of your computer, this may take a little while, but when it's done, you will have been automatically taken to the preview page where you can see how the printer will build your model. There are lots of different ways to look at the details of this preview, but the one thing I always do is use the slider on the right to move through the different layers to see that I'm happy with the way the model will print. Now, I understand that when you're starting, you're not really going to know what you're looking for here, but try and have a look at this page before each print to start to get a bit of an understanding of what the printer's going to do. In time, you'll begin to understand what might not work and catch it early. Once you're happy, you can simply select to print plate from the top right and then double check that you've got the correct printer selected and send the file. Your printer will then print out the sliced parts as per the slicer software's instructions. When the first plate is finished, clear all of the printed material from the build plate and then repeat the process for any other plates your model may have. Next, we're going to look at the other scenario, which is slicing a model that is not on MakerWorld. You may have found and downloaded an STL file from another source, like one of the many websites for 3D prints, or you may have designed something yourself using CAD software. Either way, you'll now very likely have an STL file that you need to slice before you can send it to your printer. Within the home page of Bambu Studio, select the option to create new project, which will open up a blank prepare page with an empty print plate. Again, check that the correct printer is selected and that your filament matches what is actually loaded onto your AMS or external spool holder. I'm going to print this next file on my A1, which is set up to use the external spool rather than the AMS. To import the model you want to slice, click on the cube icon at the top and then find the STL file you want to print. I'm going to print this little octopus, and once I've clicked open, I can see it on my build plate within Bambu Studio. Now, as I said before, there are lots of different settings that you can change at this stage, but if you don't know what any of the settings do, then my advice would be to start by just hitting slice plate. Once you slice the model, you can look through the layers on the prepare page and get a better idea of what might need changing. As you can see, when I slice the plate, I get a warning saying that it seems the object has floating regions. It suggests that I reorientate the part or enable support generation. If you want to see the areas that Bambu Studio thinks might be a problem, with line type selected from the drop-down menu on screen, we're looking for overhang wall. These are areas on any layout which are trying to print in thin air, which will very likely fail because of, well, gravity. So to stop these areas just dropping down, we need to put something below them to give them support. You can see that the overhang wall sections on my model are a darker blue. There are lots of little dots, which we're not going to worry about, but the nose section has a big area that is clearly trying to print in the air. To give this area some support, come back to the prepare page and under the support tab, tick the box for enable support. This time, when we slice the model, you can see that we now have lots of bright green supports all over the model, which would give us a nice reliable print, but would take ages to remove afterwards. So what I'm going to do is go back to the support options and reduce the support threshold angle down to only 5 degrees. This time when we slice, we only get supports on areas that are within 5 degrees of horizontal, which almost gives us what we want. There's a plug of support material in the middle, which isn't strictly necessary. Yes, the material in this area is printing over a void, but each end of the line has a wall to attach to. So when we check the color coding in our line type, we can see that it's not an overhanging wall that needs supporting. It's labeled as a bridge, which will likely print fine. To remove the supports in this area, there are two things I could do. I could scroll down in support options and tick the box next to don't support bridges, or I can go back to the prepare page and use the supports painting feature to block supports on the surface where I don't want them. You can see the controls if you hover over the keyboard at the bottom of the window, and I can see that right clicking blocks supports. One thing I haven't mentioned is that to move the model around within your view, hold down the left mouse button to rotate or right button to pan. Rotate the model so that you can see the surface you want to block supports on, and paint out the area with the right mouse button. Now that our model looks like it will print well, we can print plate, double check the machine, and send. If you don't have your 3D printer connected to your Wi-Fi and you want to transfer this slice file to your printer using the SD card, or you just want to save the slice file for printing later, change to a different option from the drop-down menu in the top right, and then click the button to complete the action. Once the print is complete, then removing the supports should be as simple as just pulling them free. There we go, we've now sliced and printed a MakerWorld model, as well as an individual STL, and we've also covered the basics of adding supports. This video is very far from comprehensive, and there is a huge amount that you can do with Bambu Studio when you're ready. Hopefully though, you'll now have what you need to get started. Let me know if you like this video by hitting like and dropping me a comment. If there's enough interest, I could make some more videos about some other features of Bambu Studio. Also, don't forget to subscribe so that you see any new videos that I make. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.